So with one out, here is Richie Allen. Allen has faced Lindy McDaniel many times in the National League. There's a long drive, deep center, way back, it might be. It could be. Hey, almost into the net. Holy cow. Richie Allen hit one into the up, into the center field stand. I almost got it with my net. It hit a fan's hand right in front of me.
Well, it's amazing all these years later, 40 to be exact, how many people still say 1972 was the year they became a White Sox fan.
I think it's a carryover of where we play some of that same type baseball here today. I looked at that sign coming in. It's a tradition. I'd like to think that 72 bunch, they started that tradition with Oakland. Even though they had more clientele, I thought we were just as good as them. Or as early as late as September, I think. Late August or September, we still had a grip on first place.
That year, even though you started off horrible at home, the White Sox second best home record all time was the 1972 team, 55 wins at home.
Chuck Tanner, I do say he opened up things. Like you said, he was a man of no fear. He wasn't afraid to try different things.
There's a long drive, deep right center field, way back. It drops in there. Here comes the winning run. Here comes Carlo. Here's the relay. The White Sox win.
Now, I was, those guys, I'm not kidding. We had so much fun in that clubhouse. Melton was, he was part of the big part of the glue. Shame we lost him from, what was it, a sciatic nerve. Sciatic nerve, Pat Kelly, God rest his soul. He made us go. He was our leadoff hitter and made us go, and of course, two strikes. Carlos May was very tough to strike out. We were offensively minded back then, and then out come Gossage and Forrester. Gossage, maybe 19, had no breaking ball. And have him sit right there, explaining little things about here, seeing it from a hitter's standpoint of view. So we were doing more with enthusiasm than we were with experience, and we began to enjoy it, having success together. We became tighter than pantyhose two sizes small.
Dick Allen was the leading vote-getter in the 72 All-Star game, and he played all season at a near Triple Crown pace.
Everybody would like to be known as the complete ball player, and it's not all about run, hit, throw. There's other little things that has to be picked up in the game that makes you that good ball player.
He was one of the greatest base runners that ever played the game. He knew when to go. He never made a mistake on the bases. He knocked in a big run. He was the leader with the young ball players, and it could be 110 degrees out, and he had long underwear on and 100% long sleeve shirt that hung down over his wrist, and he took that mammoth log up to the plate with it and wiggled it around like it was a toothpick. And he was the Cadillac of the day. He was the man who, at the end of the year, they had to make him the most valuable player in the league because he hit the ball as hard as anybody can.
He's got this one in line to center, Darwin over, and he falls down. Bounces over him, goes back to the screen, two runs will score. Allen is coming to third, they're waving him in. Come on, Dick, and inside the park, over out, he's got it.
I think that was Blylevin, he terrific curveball. I knew it's going to take a, he was still tracking the ball down, had to take a perfect throw to get me at home. So I wind up being safe. And again, I don't know if Burt was insisting on the same pitch, two times in one game. I'd done my running for the year.
And now with the tying runs on base, Brownell calls on Sparky Lyle, as Chuck Tanner calls on right-hand hitting Richie Allen.
I had no underclothes on. I just pulled the pants on and the shirt. Well, while I'm trying to do it, hurry up, get ready. They got me another shirt. I had chili all over the front of that one. And sure enough, I don't know the count. I think he tried to throw a slider.
Under the pitch. Oh, he screamed one. And the ball game is over. Holy cow, I don't believe it. I can hear that scoreboard going off.
I'd really like to thank you both, the Chicago White Sox and the Chicago Museum. Didn't get a chance to do that while being here those years ago, but I do get a chance to do it now. And I do say that with all sincerity and from my heart. I'd like to thank you both, as I say, the museum and the White Sox and the entire Chicago City and metropolitan area. This is a great, humbling time for me.